Hi, I'm Alex, and you're watching the MACHEREY-NAGEL YouTube channel. Today, I'm here to guide you through the essential steps for preparing your samples for nucleic acid purification using three distinct methods. Each of these methods is essential for you to obtain top-notch DNA or RNA for your molecular biology experiments. Now, determining which of these methods is more suitable for your specific experimental needs depends on various factors, such as your sample type, sample quantity, throughput, and the specific target molecules you're after. To make the right choice, it's crucial to refer to the user manual of our nucleic acid extraction kits, as it contains tailored recommendations for sample pretreatment for your unique requirements. The first method in our toolkit is bead beating. Here, we turn to mechanical force. We use small beads, a high-speed homogenizer, or a bead beater to vigorously shake and disrupt your samples. Bead beating is particularly handy for tough or resilient samples, and it can be easily scaled up for larger quantities. I show the method for bead beating exemplarily for yeast cells. To do this, add some yeast and buffer to the type C bead tube. Depending on the kit and application, lysis buffer can be added directly to the bead beating process. Close the bead tube and insert it into the bead tube holder. Give the bead tubes a good shake to mechanically break down the cells in your sample. The optimal shaking time and intensity during bead beating are determined by your specific sample type and the bead beater in use. You can find detailed guidelines in our instruction manuals. For yeast samples using bead tubes type C, we suggest shaking on the Genie 2 vortexer for 15 to 20 minutes at the highest shaking speed. At the end of the bead beating process, remove the bead tube from the bead tube holder and use the lysate for further sample preparation. MACHEREY-NAGEL offers a range of specialized bead tubes for various sample materials. Explore the possibilities on the landing page. Our second method involves a more traditional approach, the trusty mortar and pestle. This age-old tool is used to physically grind and crush your samples, making it ideal for smaller scale applications. It's a simple yet reliable way to liberate nucleic acids by breaking down cell walls and membranes. Before starting the procedure, make sure to cool down the mortar and the pestle, for example with liquid nitrogen. Then, place your sample into the mortar. Depending on your specific application, you may need to add a buffer or reagent to facilitate the grinding process. Now, using the pestle, start grinding and crushing the sample in the mortar. It's essential to apply consistent pressure while grinding in a circular motion. The goal is to break down cell walls and membranes to release nucleic acids. Periodically check the sample's consistency to ensure it's properly homogenized. Depending on the sample type, this process may take some time. Once the sample is adequately homogenized, transfer it to a container suitable for further processing, such as the microcentrifuge tube. Enzymatic digestion is our third method. It's a gentle yet effective way to break down the barriers that hold nucleic acids captive in your sample. By using specific enzymes, we can target and degrade proteins, lipids, and other cellular components that may interfere with the extraction process. This method is perfect for maintaining the integrity of your nucleic acids. One common enzyme used in this process is protease K, which is particularly effective in degrading proteins and nucleases. Protease K is often employed in various sample types, including tissue samples, blood, and other biological materials. To use it, simply add protease K to your sample in the presence of a suitable buffer. And incubate at the recommended temperature and duration as specified in your kit's manual. These were the three methods for preparing your samples for nucleic acid purification. To determine the most suitable method for your specific application, please consult our manuals or feel free to reach out to our support. We are here to assist you with any questions you may have. Stay tuned for more informative videos from MACHEREY-NAGEL. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe for the latest updates in the world of molecular biology. Thanks for watching.